Tirico, Volume 43, Want the Conclusion of the God Arc? Chapter 388, The Main Dish. His gourmet cells. Tirico just ate his own appetite demon. He just made his own appetite his. Grin. Awaken strength. After all that brawling and sobbing, you look pretty refreshed, Tirico. Huh? Tirico's like looking away. Even the tears dripping into my mouth, and greeting, an incredible taste. Huh? He's just like, come in. Then why don't we have a taste of my fist? Tariqa's like, huh? Hey. Tariqa just like, pulled back his fist so fast and then like, release it. Send him across the whole world. Boom. Push, push. He just stops him behind the fear. Huh? It's like when the park you play in as a kid looks really small when you go there as an adult. The world feels really small. Like, isn't it a stance game? What exactly is the torrential appetite? Huh? There's like food, does food like just swarm around them? The whirlwind just comes out? God, this is God's power. Boom! His main course. Tirico's full course menu, hors d'oeuvres, BB corn, soup, century soup, fish soup, ogai, memories of distant sea. He has no meat dish. Main course, God, salad, air, dessert, rainbow fruit, drink, billion bird, egg. Obtain the main dish of my full course. You all help me do this, and now all that's left is the meat dish lurking inside you, along with tons of other ingredients. My full course will be complete. Now, show yourself, Neo. This guy. So he figured out. Huh? Boom. Don't get Bambina. Bambina. You recovered by eating God. I should have expected no less. What about the other members of the Kings? Wait. Is that Guinness? That Guinness looks like. Got. Walking Moon? Moon? Yeah. Goo 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 goo. We got the Crow King. The Horse King had just given birth, so she didn't have much stamina to start out with. Make her regeneration rate slow. It will be difficult for the Crow King to recover the parts directly eaten by Neo. And it looks like it's over for the Snake King. Yeah. Tirico-san. So, like, Quinn, Terry, and Kiss are gonna take over for their respective, which is suiting. The cooking of God is complete. Preparations are a go. Huh? Komatsu. I can be later, but there are some people I want to let eat it first. That's hard, huh? If it weren't for the Eight Kings and everyone, we would have been killed a long time ago. Just a mouthful is fine. But I want them to get a taste first. Huh? Stop trying that cool, Tirico. We're perfectly fine with going last. So, Coco and Zebra. Yeah. Is that Coco in the front? Yeah. We got Sunny, Tenpai. Coco, Sunny, Zebra, Tenpai. Huh? The rope? Huh? Open his mouth. Wait, Komatsu came out? Komatsu, you did great. Wait, what? Okay, the other two? Well. He was like, the tables have turned now. That's what you're thinking, isn't it flies? No. Ooh. Wait, Midoriya? For the moment I arrived, from the moment I arrived, Our side already had the advantage, huh? Just before dying, he was knocking on him. What? You're as good at intimidating as ever. Do you have a point, Midoriya? You were able to get closest. The anger of yours gave off a nice taste. Almost to the point of reaching my appetite, but still ways off. Huh? It was like, there's something I wondered. Why do you think we eat? To live? To leave behind descendants? No. It's only because our appetites motivate us. We eat not for some sort of prosperity, nor to gain some understanding with someone. Appetite is something more selfish. Something absolute that gets prioritized over anything else. Even if you want to die, your appetite doesn't stop. Huh? Even though I'm this sad, my stomach still feels empty. Like opening his own stomach, huh? When you're hungry, you eat. In this universe, where that is all that ever happened. It was only humans that were controlled by emotion. Huh? Acacia, let me ask you one thing. Were Darge and I born from you and Froze out of love or out of appetite? Just simple appetite. Mary, huh? No love, no anger. Something that, if it swelled up just a bit, would burst. Kimuki, huh? Turn to dust and disappear. Getting ready to strike? Before something that will never disappear, like appetite. It was something fleeting that will soon smash to bits, Guru. Midoriya, even that anger of yours, could not crush my appetite in the end. Are you perhaps saying that this anger of mine will someday disappear? That's actually something I'd hope for. Good taste is the same. The good taste of the earth has already swelled to its limits. Go, 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 Aunt Earth. Everything that is built up will eventually explode and be blown to bits. But the good taste will never disappear, or will not disappear. Taste will be reborn as the next taste. Okay? Unless those worthless emotions of yours. Yes. No, actually. There's one solitary emotion, the feeling of my favorite flavors. What are you doing? I'm sure you're thinking that all of you are back, and your pieces are lined up. Who? But the one whose pieces are lined up is me. Now, allow me to chow down on your despair. He's grabbing the earth, huh? He's just shaking it. Wait. Is he actually shaking the world? Is he trying to crush the entire world in his hands? Man? Now, let's begin. Wait, Pear. You understand, no matter what happens, you must not despair. Everyone, go, 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 go. Inside the earth. On the way to the entrance of Area Zero. Go, 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 go. Huh? Swimming down. Cool. I'm at my limit. My body won't hold out anymore. Huh? That light. Is this... Oh, it's... We're at Mario. Mario? Yeah. Dupu. Huh? There's a bunch of food. What? This place. Huh? It's like erupting food all over the place. Where is he? Overflowing ingredients. This is Area Zero. What? Where did he go to? Chapter 389, the flavor he can't stand. Okay, a food utopia as far as I can see. This place, Noki, huh? Like what? Just sprouting out, hot dogs, pumpkins. What? Big trees come out. Mori. Bananas. Ingredients are. Being born one after another? What? This is a place where all life is born from. So it's like primordial ooze. The land where the gourmet cells originated, Area Zero. And along with the ingredients, their savory taste, it's like dripping out in globs. No, it's erupting and scouring all over. This is a world, 35,000 kilometers below the Earth's surface. Wait, what? So there's a layer underneath in the surface? A place where normally only those that have received God's blessings may enter Area Zero. The efforts of this unique mantle cause normal people to be sapped of their energy and dried out into mummies before they can reach it. But Amaru is a germivore. Someone that only eats pathogens. With his predisposition to enjoy eating life-flinching things. Go, 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 boo, go, boo. He's swimming in. And his ability to control what is said to be the first ever creatures. Beings born in poor conditions, microbes. He was able to adapt and survive in the rigorous journey. However, Amaru himself could not perceive that the true reason he was able to reach his destination was an invisible great power, Fudluck, that is helping him. So, Fudluck, why does Fudluck look like? Like humans. Like humanoid. Even his later actions were perhaps, this is so strange. Now that I get a good look in these mountains of ingredients, there are some that I've definitely never seen before. Huh? Like a shell? Like an egg and like a porcupine coconut? Is the Earth's good taste becoming new ingredients here? Are they being reborn? And when they swell really large, boom, they just erupt. Center gushes out from over there. This is bad, huh? The whole world is going to explode. So you're going to be like smaller? Like still crushing the Earth? Is he trying to crush the whole planet in the palm of his hand? Huh? Now, let me hear them. Let me hear your screams, minority. Now I'll just open my hand instead. Wow. Playing make believe, huh? And attack on that level. Wait, is that the dragon behind him? I couldn't forcibly cancel the entire time. I could have forcibly canceled the entire time. Midoriya's gourmet cells, meteor laser. And just taking out against huge hand. Do 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 do. So you finally use it. Goo goo goo. Your appetite. But can you stop all these? Is multiple hands he's coming out from? Wait. How's he creating these hands? Do you really think that would be enough? In that case, you. To be worrying about your own well-being. Huh? Toriko's just coming with his leg. Jet leg knife. Bambina's is coming in. And the wolves are coming in. Grah. Dark flies. Huh? Boom. Well, Bryce comes in, taking the three cooks. Dang it! Komatsu, you're gonna want to get away from here, from where the action is. Brunson, thank you so much. I'm the one that ought to be saying thanks. You did a kick butt job cooking God like that, guys. Well, the truth is, I had a lot of help from food spirits and cooking God when I was inside. Food spirits. Huh? That long haired dude? It was the same as when I was cooking another. Actually, I probably just didn't realize it. But I think I've been borrowing that power this whole time. Huh? They ain't right, Komatsu. It's that food luck. That's your power. Those things? Even though I didn't say anything. They taught me so many different things. The one thing I asked them was, if Tarigo-san and the others all eat the plant's full course, then will their bodies get taken over by the Gourmet Cell demons? No. If they eat their compatible ingredients, they'll be fine. Compatible ingredients? Yeah, we already learned about this. The ones they deem themselves, their unique full course that belongs to no one else in this world. With that, they will not be controlled by their demons or change form. That's the sole way a creature can prevent being taken over by its appetite demon. Tarigo will be alright. If I recall correctly, the first one he decided on was the rainbow fruit, correct? It just grows. It's the rainbow fruit. Huh? That's right. He's tearing up. The rainbow fruit. We captured it together. For you and Tarigo. That ingredient is one of the right ones. I'm so glad. So glad, Sniffle. Is that right? I'm pretty reassured myself hearing that. But in that case, why did Keisha appear? Why did Keisha's appearance change up so much? Could it be? Mushy, mushy. These dogs aren't even enough to fill my stomach. Cope. Huh? Midori's coming. Gourmet luck! Gua! Huh? Just take off, burn his hand. Midoriya! Hmm? This guy. Tarigo, don't move. Here. Huh? Now it's your turn. Don't budge from that spot, huh? Super. What? My giving you the human world, the Gourmet ID data, was under Keisha's instructions, huh? I'll tell you one thing. That was not to tell you Neo's capture level. The goal was to convey Neo's Gourmet Cell's color. And data of its food preferences. Color and preferences? The color of Neo's Gourmet Cells is black. A pitch black demon that swallows everything. Neo's appetite devours all things. Whether it's something natural or something man-made. Or some violent natural disaster. To Neo, everything is an ingredient. That even includes food luck. He's just sucking up from Midoriya. And I'm sure you're aware. Its favorite flavor of food is despair. But see, on the other hand, he has a flavor he can't stand. A flavor he can't stand? That is, anger. What I'm doing now is cooking. Taste change. Huh? Cooking that will change your thoughts and make emotions well up and burst out. Get angry, Tarigo. Make Neo eat the anger. That is the one way to defeat Neo. Huh? Cool. That is all, Midoriya. Gourmet punch! Boom! Gah! Midoriya's like, got something knocked out of him. So your food luck has run out. Now I can finally kill you. Acacia, what's Pear thinking? How to defeat the Acacia. Gah! Chapter 390, Acacia's Goal. Your food luck's run out. Now I can kill you. Acacia, I heard it. What did Pear hear? I could sense the voices of your compatriots from your cells. You should be happy, Midoriya. Now you can finally go suck. Okay. Now I can finally go suck Rosie's tea in the next world. Psh, Baki. And he just goes, punches that Acacia. Boom, bah. Brings out his tongue, wraps him around his foot, gets him down, starts punching his stomach multiple times. He ate his hand. Huh. So what? Huh? He's just eating his hand. Takes out, what did he hit him with? What the heck? Did he hit him with his leg? Pachi. Goes in fist. boom, dumped a fist, big explosion, wow, and Tempe and Denberry like can push back, his tongue's coming out, hunger whip, everyone run, Koga's like, boom, wow, being pushed back, it's for do. Just multiple, like, just sitting down. What? The world's gonna fall apart. He should open his mouth. What? He just, wait. Just eat Midoriya? Huh? No, he eat his tongue. And just, wait. Did he grow a tail? He just whipped it through Midoriya? What the heck? It's like an alien is eating. In this world, Midoriya, there are only two types of organisms. In the enormous food pyramid of this vast universe, Neo stands at the peak. Midoriya, you made it up pretty high, but in the end, you're one of the eaten. Enough of this farce, Keisha. Huh? It says, wait. Oh, Toriko just comes in with his hand and just chops up the food alien thing. Chops it. Tori, boku, boku. Toriko! He just wraps his spirit alien thing. Just takes out Midoriya. Huh? And just eats it. If there's only two types, then you're one of the eating two, Acacia. He just eats Acacia's thing. I don't know what it is. I'll put all my weight on my flaring anger into my fist. Boom! Just sends him flying. Midori's like, heavy eating. Midori, I'm fine. If you're doing ordinary physical attacks, and then what you need to be worried of is Neo's feeding attack. If something's eaten by him, it can't be regenerated. You need attacks with speed and destructive power that outpace his eating. No, you got backwards, Midoriya. Huh? You actually want him to eat your attacks. You're the one that gave me the hint to figure it out. Just now, when I tried eating Neo, I felt heavy stress in his flesh. It looks like only your attacks were able to do heavy damage on Neo. They didn't have a hint of Neo's favorite flavors, fear and despair. Attacks of only anger get Neo irritated. Though Okisha himself actually seems to want that. Ha. That's the farce I was talking about. Here, huh? The only thing that ever sent a shiver down my spine, Toriko, was that strange appetite lurking inside you. I'll take it from here. I know what Acacia's goal is now. Boom! What? This is bad. It's finally here. The collapse of the Earth. It's finally beginning. Good. Keisha, get up. That was a good punch. It was loaded with great anger. An incredible attack, Toriko. We gotta hurry. Okay, what do you say we finish this, Keisha? You and me. Go. Let's see those gourmet dreams come true. Hoo-hoo. It's like a face on his abdomen. Whose dream? Will come true. Wouldn't that be the one closer to the gods? No, it'll be the one that's hungrier. Huh? The spirit world, the world of spirits, and those are imprisoned there. Wait, it's true? This is quite large. No, too large. The inside is like a huge maze. It's so vast in there. It reminds me of the void in space, and it's brimming with a powerful energy. Is this life energy similar to good taste? This is two, eight. Those are the nitro, huh? Chapter 391, Acacia versus Torrigo. These are, in the soul world, there's an abundance of nitro. Not only that, they're blue nitro. What? What is that? There are so many ingredients I've never seen before. Too many. There's no end to them in sight. Wait, is he in the center? Ten, ten, ten. Saku, saku, crunch, crunch. Huh? Wait, is that Froze? You're. Boom! Let's go, Acacia! Come at me, Torrigo! Boom! They're just trading fists. Boom, just getting knocked each other out. Go full. Huh? Torrigo's coming with his fork. Flying jet fork! Boom! Boku, 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 boku. Torrigo's coming at him. Kabah! No problem. If you want something to eat, then eat this. Boom. Skin. Both taking heavy damage. He has his fist, his mouth. Is he flying backwards? Boom. The ground. Next week. Is he in Acacia now? Torrigo's in. Would Torrigo jump up? He sensed him fly up. Yeah, he sent a big blast flying up. Now, can Torrigo back? Wait, he uses his arm to, like, let the ground. On the ground now. Nice, Torrigo. It's like you're a wild beast on a rampage. But you've got a long way to go. That's not enough. Not nearly. Nearly enough. Isn't the dragon's coming? It's still round, that big lizard. It takes you too long to store up energy for that. That sky deer's. Back chomp. Got energy up to full in an instant. Idiot. You're still too slow. What? Guinness search? Cow! You shabby little stray mutt. Now, Everyone shoot at once. Put all of your anger into it. They're all just shooting at him at once. Boom. He's eating all up. Shoo. Kapoo. Ha. Ha. Kapoo. 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 You. Mickey. Mickey. Darn flies. He was able to eat that whole attack. Acacia, your body should already be at its limit. Not nearly, 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 nearly enough. He's on Guinness now? Girl, Copa. Did he just eat Guinness? He's going for a dragon? Going for the dragon? Grah! Just bites his neck? Darius! Dang it! He's lost his goddamn mind. He's gonna go try to eat everyone, or everybody. We gotta get further. Boom. Blast. Two got brushes half. Brunch! Komatsu! Komatsu-kun! Everyone! Eyes. Take out Coco. He's just finding laser beams out of his eyes. Zebra, Sunny. Bambina's come. Just tearing everything. Run, everyone! Bah! Remember when he was like, Torrigo, no matter what happens, don't despair. That's what you said, isn't it, Pear? The delicious smell coming from Acacia. Keeps growing. Just one more push. I'm sure all of us will sit around the tiny table of hope together. Everyone came here with that determination. Komatsu's like, lower half is like just blown off. An unrelenting resolve. Huh? Okay, come on. So. Now, let's end this, Neo. I'm putting everything I've got into this. My final full course of anger. Kupu, kupu, kupu. Oh, Tenpai. Then approaches from each for each of them. Something's coming out of the ground. Chapter 393. Acacia's feelings. Or Acacia's wishes. Kupua! Huh? Toriko's like, giving thanks. Huh? Why are you crying, Toriko? It's over now. So there's no need for me to stay angry. Stay angry now, is there, Acacia? You can release them now too. Yourself and Neo. That beautiful appetite. Huh? He's blown up. Appetite is an entirely pure thing. For both good and bad people, appetite is utterly straightforward and heart-wrenchingly enduring. So Toriko, you couldn't point any true seething anger against an appetite like that, even against Neo. So I, this foolish human, had to make you all angry. Huh? Foolish human, Acacia. You are calling yourself a fool. You could hear my comrades' voices. What do you mean, Pear? Actually, it's nothing. Don't worry about it. Anyhow, we'll still Neo. Just as we planned. I'm counting on your help, Acacia. Huh? A way for a body to not be taken over by its appetite demon. What would you intend to do with such knowledge, Acacia? It's possible that the cells eaten by Neo aren't completely erased from this world. If everything that Neo has eaten up to this point is living inside me, then there must be a way to rescue them back out. Such a thing cannot be done. You can't possibly be feeling some responsibility for the appetite inside of you, could you? Neo never did any acts of malice or anything like that in the past. All he ever did was eat. There's no reason for you to feel the least bit of responsibility. Not responsibility, I just want to unravel the mysteries of my own appetite. Either way, it doesn't matter. Anyway, have you finished convincing Froze? The cooking of the full course will soon be upon us. Why did Neo take me as its host? After eating for hundreds of millions of years, simply eating and eating nonstop, Neo, is your stomach really not full yet? You look at the moon. Pear! I figured out a flavor that causes Neo stress, huh? What are you talking about? That flavor might be the key to rescuing our comrades. Stop this. Are you still talking about that? I told you, there's absolutely no way to. Yes, there is! Appetite energy is constantly being reborn. Gourmet cells are the same way. There's no way they could completely disappear from this world. The absolute amount of energy never changes. Ingredients and everything else just go around and around in a circle of rebirth. Huh? We can save them. We can. See our lost comrades again. All of them. There's definitely value in trying. If we succeed, everyone will be saved. And we'll be able to eat the blue ingredients again too. Blue ingredients. Huh? Drip. Drip. Ah, sorry. There seem to be drool coming out of eyes. Those are called tears, Pear. I think this is my mission. I'd like to hear your opinion on this, Froze. I'm your combo partner, huh? All I do is cook your ingredients. Acacia, would you sleep with me today? Is that when they... Okay. If Neo's stomach still isn't full, then will my only choice be to go to the furthest land when that time comes? Furthest land. Like quotation marks. Besides constantly eating, is there any other path? Is what I'm doing really the right thing? Neo. He gets down. Please tell me the answer. If I fail, that'll mean the end of the world. If you want to stop it, Drew, then gather all the anger in your being, and please kill me here and now. along with the food, along with the food of the people, I surrender my fate to you. Huh? I cannot do that, Keisha-sama. I just can't. Keisha, after all that time of worrying and wondering, and finally find the answer of facing down your own appetite. You are no fool, huh, Pear? Thinking back, back when we saved each other's lives, was the beginning of it all. I think I'm okay with it like this. Acacia, oh no, my consciousness is fading. Is this the end? Huh? Wait, my consciousness stopped fading. What is this, knocking, huh? It was you, wasn't it, Midoriya, huh? At the moment of the final attack, you already used knocking. When did you realize my goal? When I finished off Joey. Keisha, huh? Udo, huh? What you did on him was not knocking. It was a finishing blow. What? I thought that you being the one to finally destroy Froze's body would be painful for you. Anyhow, Midoriya. That was some incredible knocking. You really are incredible at mimicking others' techniques. The first thing I copied was not a technique, huh? It was that warm love, huh? He starts tearing up. Then knocking will wear off before long. Acacia, I will not be able to stop your death. After all, I'm not like my big brother, the knocking master. Boom! It's no good! The earth! Neil's stomach was filled, but the destruction of the earth can't be stopped. Huh? Go, 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 go. Hurry, Tenpai! We're not gonna make it in time, huh? It's no use, Amaru. Even if I'm drawn all the way to the earth's interior, there's just no way I can use knocking on earth and stop the destruction. Huh? You're the only chance we got. I'm sure it's no coincidence. I came out where you are along with this explosive energy. Wait, what? Oh, Mario just comes out by a tempai. I was guided to where you are. You're the only one that can do this, Tenpai. It's just too much for me. Huh? If you don't hurry, my microbe won't be able to hold out anymore. But it's just too huge a scope. He's knocking on Earth. I don't even know where to start. Huh? Oh, Jiro comes back. Jiro. No. Right here, Tempe. He's giving me guidance. Wah! In the soul world, Ichi-chan told me I had my own role to play. Gramps? Well, knocking the world. That'll be a breeze. Won't it, Tenpai? After this, the title of master will be passed on to you. Boom! You just knock it? Huh? Huh? The destruction of the earth stopped. What's going on? Jory's looking over. I think there's only one person in the world that could pull off a stunt like this. Halting the destruction of the world. That has some problems in and of itself, though. Here, what do you mean? The baton of flavor has halted. The planet cooked with growing cells will ripen and ripen until it explodes at the very end. But the amount of that energy is incomparable to that of a supernova of a giant star. At the moment of the explosion, a huge amount of heavy elements are compounded. And at the same time, new metals like the gold material are born. Those are called gourmet materials. Good taste is compressed along with those materials, becoming the foundation of ingredients with taste unlike anything before. Those are born after hundreds of millions of years, giving birth to the full course of the next planet of plenty. So they just drift in space and create a new planet? Or, in other words, The herbs full course and the taste inherited from the plants in the past, if they don't destroy the world here, if the next full course is not created, that means the flavor baton passed around this vast universe will stop here on Earth. Still, we can't just let the Earth be destroyed, huh? This might be as far as the Earth's flavor reaches, but there are other stagnating flavors here. An amount of flavor far beyond that of the Earth, inside me, inside Neo. Acacia? You mean the ingredients that Neo has eaten up until now? Haha, huh? Wait, what? I've been waiting for this. I don't know just how much that is myself, but in the next world, my combo partner, the most beloved chef, should be cooking some new ingredients, huh? Is looking. Oh, Kupu. Wait, is he doing? Puhu? Tukutuku. Looks like this is the end for me. Now, my plan is finally complete. Though there's still one thing, Toriko. I have a favor to ask, huh? Neo, when my beloved appetite revives, please take care of it. Because he was always alone. Okay, got it. Thank you. And farewell. Boom! Just erupts. Little flavors. Villains carried out. Toriko's and Acacia's long battle is concluded. He just barfs up. Okay. Chapter 394. Toriko's full course. This villain. Ah! Wow! There it is! Tons of blue ingredients. It's been so long. Capture some, Toriko. Snip, snip. I found it. It's him. Hmm? The tasty meat I smelled coming from inside Neo. That's what it really was. What? I'm sure of it. Neo's flesh I ate came from this guy. Is that an end mammoth? End mammoth. Okay. That mammoth is said to be so delicious that the ancient Bishokii that ate it were so enamored by it that put an end to the entire Bishokia industry. It's an extinct species. Nickname, Kanzo. Kanzo means end, elephant mammoth. It can also mean liver or licorice. Okay. Did it mature inside Neo and gain even more savoriness? Oh yeah, I guess. I ain't really interested in ingredients like that, huh? But I don't think this mammoth will be putting an end to Toriko's journey. I'm gonna make this mammoth my full course meat dish. Boom! And now, Toriko's full course menu. Hors d'oeuvres, BB corn, soup, century soup, fish dish, ogai, memories of distant seas, meat dish, konzo, and mammoth. Main course, god, salad, air. Dessert, rainbow fruit, drink, billion bird egg. My full course is complete. Kaboo, kaboo, kaboo. Like something's dropping. Wah, kaboo. What the heck is this? Wah, huh? Amaru, tempai, huh? Toriko, it's liquid concentrate of center. We stopped the world from exploding. But part of center overflowed from the Earth's interior. What? Center? Acacia's hors d'oeuvres. Whoa! What incredible energy. It's like I suddenly grew a bunch of extra hearts. So this is the ultimate reviving ingredient. The ingredient that can even create life. His body is going back to normal. And everyone. That escaped death by a paper-thin margin. And having the wounds healed, is Zebra's like, she can heal too? Or is it gonna stay the same? And are being revived. Wait, Brunch is being revived? And the blood-stained land of the final battle was embracing all the wounded warriors together. Center powerfully and softly. Build the land. It's a miracle. Center covered only this area, huh? is food luck. All miracles in this world are the work of food luck. Our food luck was all eaten by Neo. So how in the world, God, was this your doing? Huh? Is the God just settled down? God is in a well-done cooked state. It no longer houses any food luck. Then, who in the world? Donkey? Wait. Oh, I see. You never know which food. You never know which luck will dwell in you. Will dwell in. Do you? What? You never know which food. Which luck will dwell in. Do you? By the way, I'll be copying that luck. Huh? Majora, but boss. Sergeant's alive? Food luck. At the very end, let the sinner, but only the small amount he can, pay for his crime. Pay for his crimes. Trigo, star. Huh? Trigo, star. This is the end of the line for me. But you brothers should be friends and sit around the same dining table. Why do you seem so happy, Midoriya? No idea. I'll turn all my energy into savoriness. Now reach all across the scar-covered plant. Huh? Gourmet spice. Huh? Now going around. Boom, boom, boom. Huh? Like sending hair over? Or is he bringing back the flavor? I shall watch. Everyone. What? And so the other chefs. Where in the world am I? Woken up, you have you, Umen? I'm glad you came where. I'm glad you came. We're able to come back to us. Hey, look. It seems the battle is over. Human world, IGO headquarters. What now? The world was totally revitalized. Trigo and the others did this. I'm sure of it. Huh? That Midoriya. Granny Sue. Do we just stand there? Thank you, Midoriya. Even after that, the eruption from Neo did not stop. It continued to expel an amount of food beyond all imagination. Enough to raise countless galaxies. Neos are like, coming out? What? I don't know for how many days that eruption went on for, but eventually Neo's vomiting finally settled down. Neo just comes out. Hey Neo, you feel refreshed after throwing up all that. You must be hungry, right? Come on, let's all eat together. Huh? After billions of years of stealing constantly day after day. This was the first time Neo experienced having food shared with him. Huh? See, oh, you like it. Haha. Okay, everybody. Huh? Let's all have a meal too. No, I just gather around. All the eight kings are around. Alright, I've been waiting for this. Yeah, the battle is over. Issues, super extra large portion. Then extended. Oh. Chapter 395. Still gathering around the dining table. Is this really a good spot? Resting there is. Huh? Wouldn't it be better to have Midoriya-san's grave in the same place as President Ichiru and Jiro-san's? You mean that training ground they have so many memories of? Food Immersion Cape? Midoriya's soul told me that here was fine, though. He said he wouldn't like being in the same grave site as brothers, because they might end up fighting again in the next world. They were on bad terms when they died, though. Midoriya said he didn't even need a grave in the first place. When I said I'd gather a full course here every week, he said I should make it here. Apparently, it's a place where he has a lot of memories of spending time with his family. The scenery that life protected. Climax. Beep, 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 beep. Huh? Ah, it's from Rinran. It's from Rinzan. She said everybody's waiting for us. Trico-san, Come on, let's get going. It's time for you, Rinsan's reception. Yeah, said the gourmet. Directly controlled by the IGO, 10-star hotel, Hotel Gourmet. Oh, I've been waiting so long for you, Toriko. Oh, Rin. Huh? That's a great dress. Can you eat it? Yeah, part of it. Wait, you can? It looks good on you, Rin. Say I'm pretty, Toriko. Come on, I want to hear it. Yeah, you're pretty. Again more. Toriko, huh? She's like crying. Huh? I'm so happy. Huh? They're all like, I'll gather up. I'm the mascot. You know how hungry everybody is. How about we get to eating? Eating Bishoka Toriko's full course. Okay, let's all eat together. In times of very full stomachs and slight hunger. Do you know Joke Bell? Huh? You know Joke Bell? To keep eating man to man until death do you part. I do. There aren't gonna be any hungry times. Who do you think I am, master? Huh? And wait, you were a priest this whole time? Wait, what? Huh? Now then, hit her with a whopper of a fully bellied kiss, enough to make everybody back away. And there's Toriko, Rinshan, congratulations. Toriko, Rin, wedding reception, full course, tasting banquet hall. Huh? Yeah, thanks. Wait, who are you? I'm Legman. Wait, what? Legman. Wait, huh? Where's my seat? Man, there's a lot of people here. Come in. Oh, the Bishoka guy. Why are you guys here? Huh? We came because we were invited. Also, I'm family. Family. Like, huh? Pooh, the more the merrier. When everyone eats together, the food tastes better. Huh? Oh, we got Neo here? Even Neo's here. Wait. They're just gonna let Neo live? Like, around them? We got around 5,000 people. This isn't just a flashy wedding. This is a super gourmet wedding. We've been invited guests from the true home of food, Gourmet World. We got tons of 10-star class chefs here too. We don't want those pros to be disappointed, so let's go cook with everything we got. They're all like ready. Yes, Chef Komatsu. Atagi-chan. You could do it on your own, and it'd probably be an easy victory. But please, let's help you out, Komachi-chan. Atagi-chan, Umu-chan. It'll be huge help. 100 people's worth. Who? The three legendary chefs said to have cooked good, are all here. Okay, the first item, the hors d'oeuvres, BB corn. Everyone, go ahead and fill your bellies. Rukumatsu's and my full course. Woo! I've been waiting for this. Man, I can't wait to dig in. Hey, Toriko. Hmm? What's that? A table? A tea table. Now that's for the food spirits I invited. I hope they come, but... Okay, let's go! Huh? First item, the hors d'oeuvres. King of corn. BB corn popcorn and chicken quench. Quench? Ooh, this is BB corn. Man, it's huge. Not only that, the stuff sparkling on it. This is the legendary spice, milk stardust. Milk's there. He's going top gear right out of the gate. I can't stop drooling. Huh? And there's other milk. The first milk and second milk. The quelch is incredible, too. It's got chicken eggs and there's something else in here. Come on, Chan. Well, why are you putting a crawdad fish and five-tailed stellar sea eagle meat in the quote? Yeah, these two were the first things I ever saw Toriko-san hunt in person. They hold a lot of memories for me. There it is. And when he first arrived, a crawdad fish. It's huge. Boom. Just takes it out into the pool. Even now, I still remember the impact I felt back then. Because that's when Toriko-san and I first met. The second item of the full course, the soup. There it is, the century soup. Wow. Incredible. It really has an aurora vapor. This isn't CG, right? Take a picture, hurry. I've got to be dreaming. Huh? I'll give you 10 billion. The century soup. Anyone that wants to take on the challenge, come with me. That's when their journey. Iso. It's huge. It's the frozen continent. Iso. There it is. This is it. The gourmet show window. The soup chose Matsukun. Huh? As its final customer to go out of the arm blown off. It won't be the last. I won't let it be the end. I swear. I'll make it again. A new century soup for this era. With modern ingredients I choose. Oh man, I can't stop smiling. I can't get this grin off my face. This century soup is just incredible. But the hermits and the frog brunch. Instead of baguette, we'll put medicinal cooking mochi wrapped in eco nori on the side. The legendary mochi that saved the people of the world from the four beasts poison. I heard about this. Huh? I found a simple method. Ha! For cooking the medicinal medical cooking mochi. Is he a genius? Grin. The third item, the full course fish dish. The once extinct species has been restored. Grilled oge with king vinegar sauce. These are extinct species of fish. And these fish on the side are amazing too. Pufferwell, shining gourmami, madam fish, and another. Unbelievable. It's a festival of high class fish. Different parts of the ogai have to be cooked for different amounts of time. Be careful of how you heat them. Come on, Chan. Hurry. We need to remove the poison from the puffer oil. Okay, leave it to me. Whoosh. This is the sandy beach of the cave. Yeah. It's like a dream. I can't believe. I'm getting to prepare a puffer oil. Yes, success! Remove the puffer oil poison sack. Just living all these memories. Speaking of puffer well, how about some fin sake? Bring on the fin sake. Prison Mensum, you're drinking too much. There's no such thing as drinking too much on a happy occasion. Mom, look, it's another. Cooking that shakumatsu made. Yes, delicious, isn't it? He's looking at he sees Jiro, old man. Is that all that came back? The fourth item, the full course's meat dish. It wouldn't be exaggerating to say, it's the meat of the last boss, Neo. Hmm? Kanzo, end man's steak. Huh? Good, Neo. They called you the last boss. Blush. What do you blush for? It's creepy. Sunny's like not even having it. Sunny and like Zebra like at the same table as Neo. On the end mammoth is slices of phantasmal garlic, meteor garlic. Ah, how delightful, light bearer. And on the side, we have the incredible food treasure from ancient times, the super special select meat of the regal mammoth, the jewel meat, as well as the meat of Gralala crocodile. It sure takes me back. This was a prey from the first journey I ever accomplished I ever accompanied Kuriko-san with on Heikamatsu. There's not gonna be any beasts past here that can be killed with a hunting rifle. Seriously? Go, row, row, row. Stand back, Matsu. Yeah! Rain. The journey to the Barren Archipelago. Back then, everything was a surprise. Wow, this jewel meat is incredible. My back sparkling. Mwahaha, of course it is. It's part of my full course. Huh? Oh, Sunny's full course? I see. I guess this is the end. I guess this is the end for me as well. Was the jewel meat tasty, Trigo? I want to eat it too. Grass Sergeant. Here it is. The fifth item. The main dish. The full course. Man, I've been waiting for this. The king of ingredients. God. Like a planet-shaped bowl. I think it's not going too far to say a lot of us came here today for just this. Rawr! You're celebrating? The main dish of my lifetime full course. The ingredient from when I said farewell to my appetite and became one with it. Just cutting it. Yes. You taste it, my appetite? Rico, huh? Wait. My appetite's with me. You taste this flavor of God. Trico, God is the one conclusion. The one conclusion to my journey. My joy is overflowing. I can't stop it. Trico, me too. Bokrine. We got Rosie. Acacia? Rosie and Acacia are there too? Acacia and one more. Huh? Pairing like Acacia are like locking eyes. God. This is God. We're eating God right now. The king of ingredients. That once stopped a great war. Finally. A chance to eat God. To think that a day would come. When such a big crowd would be able to share God together. I don't know how to express the joy I'm feeling right now. I just don't know, but for now. Seconds on God! Huh? Present Mansum! Huh? You want seconds of the divine ingredient? Is that allowed? Is there even any more? Then I want seconds too. Me too. Me. I want some too. A new order of God. God's already fully cooked. So we can pretty much put it out as it is. You know, focus on the next item on the full course. Huh? Okay. Back in the kitchen. If we're not tactful, God will have too strong an impact, and all the customers will fill up on it. Come on, Chan. We need your help on this too. The orders keep coming. Takachan. What is it? This is like a dream, doesn't it? What does? Everyone's eating God together. Can't believe such a day has come. It really feels like a dream. Come on, Sean. What are you crying for? And at a busy time like this. Yeah. Okay, let's get cooking. The sixth item. The full course salad. There it is! The food treasure heir! I got a big leap. The legendary ingredient. Just keeps coming. Heir. Harvested in our country. You must be happy, huh, old man Durama? And the leaf placed on top of air is another high-class ingredient. Purin, the king of vegetables, the ozone fruit, or ozone herb. Komatsu, now that we safely captured the ozone herb, there's something I want to say to you. Would you form a combo with me? She's crying. Form a combo with me, and we'll create the ultimate full course together. Ryan, the seventh item, the dessert of the full course, the seven-colored, overwhelming sugariness. There it is! Oh man, I can't wait! The memorable first ingredient chosen in Toriko's full course, the sweet dessert, the rainbow fruit. Like, three different fruits are just suspending it. Jakumatsu, you remember that day, aren't you? He's just gushing out. He sure is crying a lot. Komatsu, get this stuff together. I've decided on one of the items. My full course. So how about we all celebrate together? Boom, boom, rainbow fruit. Boom. Today we prepare the rainbow fruit as a jelly. And it has some ingredients, contents inside. And it has some incredible content inside. I'm not reading this right. The human-faced apple. The surprise apple. An astonishing surprise level 100. Oh! It got a full apple. The temple treasure of Shokuren Temple. The bulb fruit. And the smellest food in the world. Also known as a stink bomb. Huh? No way. Is that it's the Dororian bomb. Yeah, it really is. It stinks. But it curtailed the smell. So, haha. Just plugging his nose. Man, this smell really takes me back. Once you get used to it, it's really addicting. What are they saying smells? Because the Dororian is great. I want some more. Huh? Seconds of the bomb? Huh? Seriously, Zangiesama? And finally, the eighth item of the full course, the drink. It's here, the final item. The legendary ingredient that saved the human world when food supplies went dry for a whole year. Spa-wah. After people all over the world were surviving purely on tablets. This reminded us of the joy of eating. It's the billion bird egg. This is it. This is what saved us. The end of Trico's full course. Was the signal of the first cry of the new gourmet age. The egg of a new beginning. But if we eat this, it'll make our eyelashes grow. For the drink today, I mixed it with Melicola, making it a billion bird mellow drink. Ah, it's Chef Komatsu. Chef Komatsu's here. Chef Komatsu. Thank you, Chef Komatsu. Komatsu. Why are you crying, Chef Komatsu? The fizz of the mellow cola got in my eyes. Can't stop crying. I'm sorry. Huh? This is my old man's full course. The infinite ingredient, the billion bird. Huh? Giving toast to Ichiru. Ichiru's looking over. Huh? Wait. Midoriya? Joey's there. Huh? Come here, Midoriya. Let's all eat together. He's welling up. They're all welling up. He's just crying, burst out. Okay. They all grew younger. Friends, like. Now sink your teeth into happiness. Next issue, the grand conclusion. Wow. Chapter 396, still yet unseen ingredients. With thanks to all ingredients, it's been a feast of a color page. Now where will we go next? We squeezed among glistening ingredients, a meeting. Seven food with his blue demon and his pink demon. Or his appetites. Between Terigo and his appetites. Since Terigo and Rin's wedding reception, a few years have gone by. Wah! So this is your new fairy tale castle. Huh? It's like a fairy tale come true, or come to life. Fairy tale castle? Tori no Shiro? An orphanage where you can meet God. Your dream's finally been realized, huh, Taki-chan? Thank you, Komachi-chan. Thanks to help from the IGO and the Sensei Association, we're able to selectively breed and artificially cultivate God. I wouldn't have been able to make this castle without them. Now, outside original goal of child care, we're getting tons of requests to stay for kindergarten. Huh? Well, What do you expect when you King got there? Even adults would love to come. It's famous for how the kids that leave here go on to live their lives vigorously, with their heads held high. Yeah, and if they ever stumble, they're always welcome back. They're always welcome back. After all, warm cooking and the King ingredients will always bring one back to the fairy tale world. By the way, what's Umi-chan doing? Umi-chan is teaching cooking at Nakagumi's cooking school. Apparently, they've been flooded with students, hoping to get the teacher who cooked God. Ha! I hope his hair doesn't go white again. Oh, he turns back normal. Come on, Chan. I'm guessing it's the usual for you. Going on journeys with your legendary combo partner, right? That's right. Trico-san called me, and it's about time to go. I better get moving. Okay, see you later, Taka-chan. Whoa, why such a rush? Where are you going this time, Kama-chan? Outer space. Wait, what? Outer space. Huh? Space? Oh, be careful. A big fly. Oh, Trico's fishing again. The giant grasshopper. Huh? Trico-san! Oh, you're late, Komatsu. I was just stopping by Taka-chan's place. You know, the weather sure is nice. Somewhere along the line, the sun went back to normal, so bright. Alright, I figured out the secrets of the gourmet super... Alright, I figured out the secrets of the gourmet solar eclipse, Komatsu. Oh, really? Yeah, it wasn't too hard. Apparently, these invisible, gigantic gourmet satellites were blocking out the sun like potlids. What? Gourmet satellites? What are those exactly? They're man-made cooking satellites made of gourmet matter. Apparently, they were originally made by the nitro of the nitro to cook the planet. Cooking satellites? Wait. So they're giant cooking. They're giant cooking implements. Yeah. Well, yeah, basically. I think it means instruments. Huh? I can't even grasp something on a huge scale like that. There aren't any giant frying pans or pots used for cooking plants out there, are there? Apparently, yes. There are. Huh? There are fairy tales that a long time ago, the giant demon kings that used them would take bites out of sun. Wait, they would eat just suns? But those might not just be stories. What do you mean? A team of gourmet astrology researchers have observed gourmet energy from directly after the gourmet Big Bang. Through Acacia's full course. We're able to capture electromagnetic waves. We weren't able to before, and that's what led us find out all this. But the really shocking thing is that image. It looked like a harmonious family gathered around a dining table having a meal. What? It's like, okay, huh? Are you serious? Giant creatures sitting around some stars eating? Not stars. What they were sitting around was a galaxy, 10 light years in diameter. Galaxy? Just how big are these creatures? About that, I asked a few questions to appetites inside me. Your appetites? And they told me quite a bit. Long ago in a place called the Furthest Land, so it's actually a place, a world where gourmet gods lived, an appetite inflation took place, causing gourmet energy to explode all at once. That was 13.7 billion years ago, the gourmet Big Bang. Along with the expansion of space, from the magnitude of ingredients that were scattered at a tremendous speed, were ingredients that a certain family of gods carried with them and protected. The planetary full course. But that family was also scattered by the force of the Big Bang. Before long, the Gwangmae energy had expanded for many years and formed several spaces as it turned the colors of each family member's favorite ingredients. Black, red, white, green, blue, but no yellow or purple. Okay. So the gods are said to have continued to protect the full course in their own spaces. So that even if their food preferences differed, the full course would someday bring them all back together. The colors of the family were: the father was black, the mother was white, the elder son was red, the second son was green, the third son was blue, apparently. Huh? That kind of sounds like Acacia-san and the other families. Acacia-sama's Gwangmae cells, Neo's were black. Maybe Frozen-san's were white. The appetite that felt like it would envelop anything, and didn't have a speck of dirtiness in it. Then was my old man red, Jiro green? Did Jiro even have a demon? Maybe Tenpai had green hair. Because the color skips a generation. I don't know if Midoriya was blue, but that might have been the case. By the way, the Buddha-looking guy in me is white, apparently. Huh? You think the initials of the full course spells Pangaea? Maybe that furthest land where the gods lived. Fragmenting Gwangmae energy of those crazy gigantic Gwangmae gods is the true identity of Fuzak. Really? They may have led us to that land, and because of the effects of Adam, of the full course, Gwangmae matter has been gradually become invisible for me. Now that I can see it clearly, outer space looks like a Gwangmae food paradise. Ah, Trigo-san, you got a bite. Oh, all right. I hooked it. Wow, what is that? Huh? This is a shellfish. It looks so familiar. Ah, wait. Is this that species from Blue Grill in Area 6? A giant shell? This is a baby. Yeah, but it's just a baby. I think I'll call it minimum shell. It's a baby. This is a baby? The team of Gwangmae astronomers remodeled the shell into a spaceship for me. Huh? Then this is a space camping monster? Yeah. I've been raising it in this lake. Huh? Okay, what do you say we get going, Komatsu? What? We're going already? Kurigo-san, you need to tell Rin-san about this, right? Yeah, I told her I'm going out for a little hunt. A little hunt? We're going to outer space. We don't even know when we'll be back. When we'll get back. Relax. Minimum shell can pass light speed and slip through gaps in space-time. In other words, it's a back channel. Even if we're traveling for years, reverse Uramashi effect. Well, let's get back to Earth in just a few days. Psh, open up. But is anyone coming with us? Like Coco, Sunny, or Zebra-san? Yeah, about... what about Terry? Terry went back to his pack. Huh? Yeah. That fight with Neo drove all of the then active eight kings into retirement. Though all their wounds healed, any king that suffered even one loss is no longer a king. Now in Gwangmae World, there's a battle of warlords to capture the title of the next eight kings going on, and Terry's part of it. Big Kong, dang. Speaking of which, apparently a lot of wild beasts from Human World have tossed their hats into the ring. That the Troll King, Devil Orochi, and Regal Mammoth, they've all gotten way stronger. Boy with Komatsu. Kogun and others are already traveling through space. Huh? Really? Kogun's ever said they're looking in space for the last item on their full courses. Huh? You mean with space ingredients? We gotta get moving too. Or Zebra's gonna eat it all. Okay, let's jump off, Komatsu. Okay, Tariko-san. Whoa. Someone once said that somewhere in this universe, there are sweet stars that are just like flour dumplings. Flour dumpling stars. That in giant planetary craters, there is fizzy sherbet endlessly bubbling out. That there is a pack of delicious elephants, each as big as an entire star, cosmos mammoths, that form a nebula. The door. That there is a space food repository that only appetites can enter, a space pantry, within which many yet undiscovered ingredients rest, and new ingredients are always being born and growing. That sometimes gourmet gods pilfer those ingredients. That the gourmet paradise where those gods once lived, the farthest land exists. That there, God ingredients beyond imagination, flooding out endlessly. The people of the world thought that they wanted to eat those things. Look, Komatsu. Mitarashi Dango plants. Huh? The Mitarashi Dango are a kind of dumpling skewed with sticks and glazed with sweet soy sauce. They look so good! Got a turtle in space? Yeah! Something just popped out, Tariko-san. It's like a snake. Plant snake. Let's get those dingoes first. They're way too big. Huh? It's a space taipan. Okay, let's fight. You wanna fight that? Ha! Huh. As long as they live, their stomachs will rumble. So the adventure does not end. Thank you all so much for 8 years of readership. Check further reports for remaining volumes and the author's next work. And that is the end of volume 43 of the God Arc. So they go in space. I wonder if it's like, there's a big gun. Space. Back. It's like in the corner, there's just a gun. Okay, wow. I guess this is a fitting, like, conclusion to the story. This is a conclusion, and there's not more. If you haven't already, subscribe to that comment. Leave any suggestions and recommendations down below also. And have a good rest of the day. Bye.